Welcome back to Shop Talk. I'm Urieta and Juan Cotrillo, and we're talking about the Southern Fair. It's a weekend market that will open every Sunday starting September 18th for 6 months after that at the PhilInvest Corporate City. And with us now are two of their concessionaires, Zarah Juan, she's the owner of Coco Manila, and Gail Miller, she's the owner of Organic Mama's Grocery. Ladies, welcome to Shop Talk.
Thank you for having us here.
Okay, let's start with Zarah. How did you end up making soaps? So,
this is actually just a hobby that I share with my best friend. And then normally we would go to Baguio every month to be with our families, with our kids. And then we discovered kasi in Baguio Market, there are so many ingredients or natural ingredients there that not only good for, let's say, for food, but also good for the skin. So we started playing around with all the ingredients that we found there, and then nabuo na yung Coco Manila.
Okay, so, but where did you actually learn how to make the soap itself?
The soap making, there's a friend of mine who's a scientist in UP Los Baños who's into natural products also. She makes organic, what do you call this? Virgin coconut oil.
Oh, I see.
And then she taught me how to make soaps. And of course, researched them with Google, YouTube, and books.
That's right, using all the resources. And then came Coco Manila. And it's actually making its debut at the Southern Fair,
yes,
right?
Yes, this is going this is going to be the first time na ilalabas namin sa Manila.
Okay, all right. Now, for Gail, of course, you are into natural products, but not the kind that you slather on your skin, more the type that you eat. Tell us how Organic Mama's Grocery came about.
Well, our family also transitioned into more of a healthy lifestyle, not just organic, also all natural. And on weekends, I would have to wake up early, go to the market, and source out from everywhere just for our family, and it got to be really tiring for me that I decided to put up my own business in the south, because I figured, you know, we lack that in the southern part of Manila.
Okay, so when you say you know, the problem with organic is it's such a loosely thrown around term here in the Philippines, and we don't really have like a body to regulate the use of the word, right? But your stuff is really organic, no chemicals, no pesticides, no hormones.
Okay, some of them are 100% organic and some are all natural. Like the vegetables are certified organic and the beef is grass-fed, so it varies per product.
Okay, so if it's not completely organic and it's all natural, what does that mean?
Like, for example, like the beef and the chicken, when you say it's organic chicken or organic meat, they have to be fed organic feeds as well, which we don't really have here in the Philippines, not yet. So actually, there's really no such thing as organic meat here in our country, so we just have to go with all natural, meaning to say they eat vegetables and fruits, not organic though, and then there's no antibiotics and no hormones.
Okay, so that's sort of okay middle ground, I suppose, concerning what's available in the country now. Mm-hmm. All right, and is this the first time you guys will be selling at a fair or a bazaar of this type?
Yes.
Okay, so you guys must be really excited. How are you preparing for the Southern Fair?
With us, of course, we would like to showcase all our best products. In Baguio kasi, we were able to find Sagada Orange. So we have a very nice soap, which we call Sagada Orange Soap.
And it's really made from the oranges from Sagada.
Yes, right. Okay. Yes. And we also have this Benguet Coffee Scrub Soap. So it's very nice, the skin is very soft. Yeah. And all our soaps kasi, we use goat's milk, which we get naman from Ilocos.
Okay, I love that it's all, you know, local stuff that you're using.
That's the vision with Coco Manila. We would like to highlight all natural ingredients that we can find locally.
Right. And what's the price range for the soaps?
We sell one bar soap for 150 pesos.
All right, no matter what kind of variant it is. They're all priced the same. Mm-hmm. Very nice. All right, and for Organic Mama's Grocery, Gail, what would you say are your best sellers?
It would have to be the meat, the beef, because the price is not as expensive as the other, like with the chicken, it's more expensive than the regular chicken that you buy, but for my beef and pork, they're actually supermarket price, except, you know, you get all the, it's natural.
Right.
So,
Okay, because that's, I think, a conception or an idea that people have when it comes to trying to go organic. Ay, mahal. Ay, it's hard to find. It's, you know, this and that. But for now, before the fair starts, you're selling out of your home, you have pickup, delivery.
Yes. I do sell from my house, and I do deliveries, and some people go to the house also to just pick them up.
Okay. For deliveries, you have like a minimum order?
Yes, there is. And as of now, I only deliver around the Alabang area, Alabang, BF, Parañaque, and Las Piñas.
Okay. But I think you're going to have to think about that one after the fair if people hear about you and people from wider or more far-flung places find out about it. But so far in your businesses, what are the challenges that you guys have encountered?
Well, for me, it's really sourcing out because right now there's a lack of producers, organic producers, and also the weather. With our weather now, it's hard to get vegetables. Like the farm where I get my vegetables from was washed out by the storm, so it's really hard to source out, but we need to, I guess. I need to.
Right. With us, naman, it's finding the venue to introduce our products since it's all natural products and we would like to have people to appreciate what we have to offer. So I think launching this product in Southern Fair is very nice because finally we could have a captured market who shares the same vision and the same, same lifestyle, natural and organic.
Right. And speaking of, you know, getting others involved, I understand that your business has like a livelihood aspect to it.
Yes. Oh, since my friend is from Ilocos and this is just a hobby that we make, so we thought of sharing the business with a lot of people in Ilocos, especially the mothers, because we want them to learn that they can find ingredients around them lang na hindi nila kailangan bumili outside. So, like right now, we teach mothers in Ilocos, particularly in one city, it's in Candon City. We are teaching them how to appreciate what they can find within their area, such as in Ilocos, we found out that there is Acapulco, there's guava, there's chocolate. So, these are all nice for the skin. So yon.
Chocolate to eat and chocolate for the skin.
Yes,
I like it.
Actually, the chocolate oil is very good for the skin. It's very moisturizing.
Interesting.
It's rare though, but it's available in Ilocos Sur. So we tell them that you should appreciate what you have here.
That's right. Mm-hmm. Okay. And for you, Gail, I'm sure, you know, when people come to you, they also have like a lot of questions about going organic, which is what you and your family are trying to do.
Yes.
Do you find that you've sort of become like a resource person or people ask you questions and more information?
Well, a little bit, yes. And I do try to answer the questions as much as I can, as best I can. But of course, you know, I'm also learning and I'm learning from my suppliers. And I'm very lucky to have established suppliers who have been in this business forever. And they teach me also, they educate me as well.
Yeah, it's a great network actually, I think.
Yeah.
Right. Okay, so what can we expect from you guys at the fair? Will you be launching anything, coming out with any surprise new products? Will you be part of any demos?
For Southern Fair, we're going to teach kids and mothers on how to create a homemade soap. So we're going to have a soap making events in Southern Fair. It's going to be, I think, this coming September, the first month of Southern Fair.
That's right. And for you, will you be participating in any of the events, Gail?
I'll be supplying some ingredients for some of the cooking shows for the fair.
Oh, that's right. Because Joyce was saying earlier, there'll be a competition and the chefs will be buying produce from the sellers and making food out of that. And both of you are mothers, of course, right? Mm-hmm. How has that affected your business? Because I know a lot of moms in business, a lot of the things they do are inspired by their kids.
Yes, that's true.
It's actually a constant struggle. So you really have to find time to delegate and to divide it according to your priorities. So if you're a businesswoman and you have a lot of things to do, you should always remember what is your priority. And of course, being a mother, the priority is, of course, our kids.